Slash and Boom was a song that hadn't been written until we got to the demo studio, House in the Woods in Surrey. It was all written when we did our first demo session with Steve Brown. It was as another song that has his fingerprints all over it because, you know, we'd written verses and choruses, and then he said, no, he needs a middle section, et cetera, et cetera.
Well, the dum 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 dum
down the Michael Schenker bit. So I just remember really loving that lyric, actually, but a lot of people slag it off since, so I'll...
That's a great lyric. Yeah, I think it's pretty much a lot of Richie's words in that, if I remember rightly. Stonesy title, Stonesy riff.
It was supposed to be a Stonesy, if it was supposed to be the Stones playing metal, the riff was, basically.
What it is?
Yeah, so there you go.
NatWest Barclays, Midlands, Lloyds. It was a bit of a cornerstone when we were doing it, wasn't it? It was one of the, meant to be one of the big tracks of the record. And a lyric that is kind of more hauntingly prescient than it ever was. Black Horse Apocalypse and all that. I think it's a, spent quite a lot of time on there, writing it with Richie. I think if anything sums up, sort of giving, trying to cram millions of words into a song, is that chorus, you know.
And that was, yeah, musically, I think I was trying to get a couple of Faith No More references in there, which is probably kind of like me giving away where my head was at that point in time. But Dave Aringer plays piano at the end of it, who went on to produce us quite a lot after that. Yeah.
I really like Born to End. Me and Richie were searching for a title for months, trying to a kind of Stonesy sort of title with a Stonesy riff. I remember playing it in Japan and people going absolutely mad for it.
Yeah.
The Nagasaki line. It's a bit scary.
Nagasaki dolls are burning, and there's kind of a thousand Japanese audience just like singing that towards you. Just kind of confused me. I don't know whether to smile or just turn away at that point.
Born to End's also famous for Sean doing backing vocals live for one gig.
Yeah, the first time you did that was Bristol University.
Yeah.
You had a headset on.
Yeah.
And then you didn't do it again.
But never again.
It was brilliant as well.
I guess. Drummers who sing.
Born to End. Like Martin Chambers from The Pretenders.
Awful, sorry.
It's a really good demo, Born to End as well. So kind of
drums
like
are fantastic on the demo. Motorcycle Emptiness. It's a fusion of two songs.
Yeah.
Or maybe three, you know. I've still got the demo of two. The one of them, Behave Yourself Baby, Sean plays trumpet on, doesn't he?
Yeah. So there's a middle section in Behave Yourself Baby, which end up as the middle section in Motorcycle Emptiness. There's a song that was called Go Buzz Baby Go, which is the...
Go Buzz Baby Go!
It's the core of the song of Motorcycle Emptiness.
And it's and the verse, tumbling down
your spine. Yeah, so the verse and chorus from Go Go Buzz Baby Go. And then we'd smash those parts together at kind of Brownie's best in kind of House in the Woods. And then he said, now he needs a solo. So the solo part got written in House in the Woods.
Arnie first introduced us to the notion of programming drums as well, to try and get away from acoustic drums, which I think personally he found it more difficult to record acoustic drums than he did to record electric guitars.
He had a program.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As in, you know, this is the way I record.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's kind of, you know, the demo was kind of, we spent a lot of time putting that demo together and kind of, and we went for our version of something which was slightly baggy, which was strange.
Yeah.
Kind of thing,
I can remember ordering all the drum machines and computers on the Friday, and by the Monday, managed to get it sussed.
Concord Q-Pace.
Yeah, so that was me for the whole album there. Working through the night.
So sounds a bit dramatic, but kind of, it was kind of always feel as if that was a song that saved us, in a tiny sense.
Yeah.
Oh, well, You Love Us was a song that was written way back in Valleys, kind of thing. I remember, was I just you lyric or was it you and Richie?
No, it's both.
It's both. I remember getting the lyric and I was down in the kitchen of my parents' house in Swabers Road in Pontefract. And I think I had the chorus and you did the verses, I think. I remember just doing it there. The Rayburn was kind of glowing in the middle of winter. And just remember thinking this, it was the first song we'd written, which was kind of close to a Pistols song. Mm. And kind of, I remember you having a big discussion about, you know, we've got to try and do We Love You, but in a different way.
That was it.
No, you Love Us.
Totally. Again, we searched for that title. Richard came up with the title in the end. We were totally trying to invert the idea. I mean, it is the kind of quintessential early Manic song. You know, it is sort of so much bravado in those words. Spectacular kind of, considering at the time no one did love us at all, you know. I remember, he was at some do at Sony, and the album had been out, and Noel was there, do you remember?
Yeah.
And they maybe just signed to Sony?
Yeah, and he came up and he said, you know, You Love Us, it's Pistols, man, it's Pistols, great guitar sound. And Paul Weller said he loved the rhythm guitar playing as well, to Philip Ball. So there was some good little, I don't know if any of these people can remember it, and they think we're making it up, but, you know, they did say it. Love Sweet Exile, jeez.
I think when we did it at the O2 in December, you know, when we played all the singles, after this is pretty much the only time I've ever really loved that song.
Yeah, we spent years, decades hating that song. Then, like I said, we played at the O2, we loved it again, and now we've gone off it again.
It's the most un-Manix record in every way. It's got a program throbbing bass.
And the machines took over. But kind of Richie liked the fact that it had this program bass in it because it was a bit of a Nine Inch Nails thing, he thought. But again, that song had been in the past a song called Just Can't Be Happy.
Faceless Sense of Void.
Faceless Sense of Void.
And actually, I've got a copy of the lyric which me and Richie are working on. It's just called We Hate You.
So yeah, that's another song that kind of, old Brownie, kind of like developed.
Brownified.
It's a fucking amazing guitar solo, though, you've got to say. It's just amazing. Whittles.
Was that one take or did it take?
Yeah, one take.
It was two takes. Yeah. There was one half and then the other half came.
Saturday and Sunday.